Hello everyone, today I am going to explain the calculation of pull up and pull down ratio for an NMOS inverter driven through one or more pass transistors. Okay, so here for that one I am taking here the inverter 1 and inverter 2. Okay, and the output of this inverter, it passes through the pass transistor and that is given to the input as input for the inverter 2. Okay, so here we have inverter 1 and inverter 2, and this inverter 2 will driven through the pass transistors. Okay, so here there is pull up to pull down ratio for an NMOS inverter driven through one or more pass transistors. Okay, so for this circuit, for this statement, this is the circuit what I have considered. Here I have two inputs, that is two inverters, inverter 1 and inverter 2. And in between that we have the pass transistor. Then what is pass transistor? Okay, pass transistor is nothing but an NMOS transistor, a MOS transistor. Okay, so in which not only the input given to the gate, but also we can give the input through the drain. Okay, so that is the property of a pass transistor, and this is the technology that is generally with if you consider the CMOS technology. Okay, so it is sometimes more advantageous than the CMOS technology in terms of some logic circuits. Okay, so that is about the pass transistor. We can not only give the input at the gate, but also we can give the input at the drain of the MOS transistor. That is the property of pass transistor. Okay, so it will passes whatever we are giving here through to this one. Okay, so that is about the circuit for the given statement here. Okay, now here I am considering that the inverter 1 we have and inverter 2 we have. Okay, so here the inverter 1 consists of inverter 1 and inverter 2 consist of depletion MOSFET load, and at the same time we have enhancement transistors. Okay, so here in this condition, to derive the pull up and pull down ratio, okay, so I have considered that the two transistors whatever we have, that is depletion transistors. Okay, so here I am representing, this is the inverter 1 circuit and this one is the inverter 2 circuits. So this one is the depletion transistor. What is this diagram on this one? Why I have represented, I will tell now. So this one is the first one indicates inverter 1 and it's a depletion load, a depletion MOSFET or pull up transistor. And this one is the enhancement transistor, that is pull down transistor. Okay. Similarly here also for inverter 2. So here we have to calculate what is the output of this inverter 1 and what is the output of this inverter 2. Okay, so here the depletion transistors are considered as in saturation region of operation. Okay, saturation region of operation, and They will act as constant current sources. So for this point, this one is the constant current source representation. Whenever in the previous discussions I told that the saturation region of a FET or MOSFET can be used as a constant current source. Okay, because in the saturation region the current will be constant. Okay, so this one and this one is the representation of constant current source, and depletion mode transistors will be in saturation. And the second case is first one, and second assumption here or second one is, so we have to operate this one in non-saturation or ohmic region. Okay, enhancement transistors are meant transistors आर इन 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 लीनियर आर ओमिक रीजन. ओके लीनियर आर ओमिक आर वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट. ओके वोल्टेज वेरिएबल रेसिस्टर. वोल्टेज वेरिएबल रेसिस्टर resistor. Okay, so enhancement transistor can be used in the linear region and operated in linear region. At that point it will be acts as a voltage variable resistor, and that is represented as like this. Okay, now here if we observe that, so this one is in saturation region and it will be constant current source, and here we have I1. Okay, I1 is the current. And here if you have your V2, that is inverter 2, that is nothing but I2 is the constant current, that is due to the depletion transistor or pull up transistor. Similarly here it will act as a voltage variable resistor when it is operated in ohmic region or linear region. So if you observe this one, this is the characteristics of a transistor, that is MOSFET. So if you observe this one, saturation, and this is nothing but the linear region or ohmic region. Ohmic region. So that's why here it is considered as operated in ohmic region enhancement transistor. It will be operated in saturation region. Okay. So now I will consider the calculation of R1 and I1, and at the same time Vout1, that is the output of inverter 1. Okay. For that one, here I will show that first heading is calculation of R1, I1 and Vout1. R1, I1 and Vout1. Okay. So for this purpose, I am going to use the IDS versus VDS relation, that is nothing but IDS equation for saturation and non-saturation regions. Okay, so here we have, here also we can write, here it will be operated in non-saturation region. Sorry, here it is non-saturation. Enhancement transistor will be operated in non-saturation or ohmic or linear region. At that point it will be acts as a voltage variable resistor. Okay, so now I am going to calculate R1. Okay, after that what we have Vout1 and all those things. Okay, so now if I go with this, first I will consider for non-saturation region. So what is the equation of IDS for now? Here I will consider the enhancement transistor that is operated in non-saturation region. Okay, for non-saturation region of enhancement transistor IDS is equal to that is K into W by L. Okay, K into W by L. So here we have VGS minus VT, VGS minus VT multiply with the VDS minus VDS square by 2. Okay, so this is the equation of a transistor, enhancement transistor that is operated in non-saturation region. Then IDS is equal to K into W by L, VGS minus VT into VDS minus VDS square by 2. Okay. Now, here we will apply this one to this transistor. Okay. So, therefore, here I will consider that. Okay. So, IDS is equal to, here I will consider this. Here K is equal to epsilon naught, epsilon insulator, mu by D. So this is the K value what we have generally, right? So IDS is equal to this one. Now what I have to consider here, I have to apply for this enhancement transistor, this equation. Okay, so if we apply that one here, the input for that transistor I am considering is Vin is equal to VGS is equal to here VGS is equal to VGS is equal to VDD. I am taking VGS is equal to VDD, and at the same time VDS is equal to I am taking as VDS1. VDS is equal to VDS1. Okay, so VGS is equal to VDD and VDS is equal to VDS1, right? So I am substituting here these values in this equation, and here at the same time it is pull down transistor, that's why I will use here is equal to WPD and L is equal to LPD, right? Okay, and this VDS1 is very small. I am taking that very small value. Okay, what I am doing, the generalized equation I am applying to the enhancement transistor, that is T3. Okay, at that point I will consider VGS is equal to VDD and VDS is equal to VDS1 and it is very small, and W is equal to WPD and L is equal to LPD because it is a pull down transistor. Okay, so therefore if I substitute these values here, IDS is equal to, so I will get here, that is K into WPD by LPD, WPD by LPD, and it is VGS is nothing but VDD minus here VT, as it is I will take that one, that is threshold voltage of NMOS transistor, VDD minus VT, and here it is VDS1 minus VDS1 whole square by 2. So this is the equation, modified equation for this transistor T3 or enhancement transistor. Okay, now I am taking VDS1 common, so therefore IDS is equal to K into, so it is what, WPD by LPD. So but here we know that ZPD is equal to LPD by length of pull down transistor by width. So therefore if you take or if you substitute in place of this, so what you will get here, that is 1 by ZPD pull down transistor. If I take this one here instead of that, and at the same time I am taking the VDS1 as common here, so it is VDD minus VT minus VDS1 by 2, and it is multiplied with the VDS1. Okay, right? So it is nothing but IDS is equal to K into, it is LPD by WPD is equal to ZPD, and it is multiplied with VDD minus VT minus VDS1 by 2, that is VDS1. Here I am taking that in this one common term, that is VDS1. So at the same time the VDS1 here we have. Okay, so now I will consider here, I want to calculate first the R1 value. Okay, so for that purpose I have to calculate this R1. So generally what resistance is equal to, okay, so V by I, right, V by I. So therefore I will calculate R1 is equal to here VDS1 by IDS, VDS1 by IDS, right? So what we got here, IDS value is this one. So directly you can substitute that, so that what you will get here, VDS1 is as it is by, what about IDS? IDS is equal to K into 1 by ZPD, K into 1 by ZPD, and it is VDD minus VT minus VDS 1 by 2 and it is VDS 1. Okay, so just I am substituting that in place of VDS 1 as it is, and IDS is equal to this one, that is 1 by K by ZPD VDD minus VT minus VDS 1 by 2 minus, multiply with VDS 1. So here if you observe this, this one and this one will be cancelled. Okay, and finally what you will get here, R1 is equal to this ZPD, it will goes to the numerator, so it will be ZPD by K, ZPD by K, and it is nothing but as it is, it will be there, that is 1 by VDD minus VT here, VDD minus VT, right? So that's what here IDS means, ZPD will go here, and here VDS1 is small, VDS1 is very small, okay? So VDS 1 by 2 is very very small, so neglect VDS 1. So here VDS 1 is very small, okay, and VDS 1 by 2 is very very small, so I can neglect VDS 1 by 2 from this equation, and whatever the remaining I have, I am writing here. Therefore, R1 is equal to, this is the equation. So, R1 is equal to, what we got? R1 is equal to ZPD by K, and it is 1 by VDD minus VT. Okay? So, this is the equation of R1. Right? This is the equation of R1. So this equation I am taking as equation number 1, right? Okay, now we will calculate the I1. Now what we have to do, I got R1, to calculate the V out 1, so I have to calculate I1. For that purpose, calculation of I1, how I can calculate? So this is the depletion mode transistor and it is operated in saturation region. Okay, transistor T1 is in saturation mode. So IDS is equal to it is K into W by L, K into W by L, it is actually VGS minus VT whole square by 2. This is the generalized equation for the saturation mode of operation. Okay, now we will extend this equation to the transistor T1. Okay, so here if I extend this one to the transistor T1, that is in saturation region. Okay, here IDS is equal to I1, I will take IDS is equal to I1, because in the saturation mode it will act as a constant current source. So it is IDS is equal to I1, and VGS is equal to 0. For depletion mode transistor, VGS is equal to 0 and VT is equal to VDD. Okay, and VT is equal to VDD, and W is equal to what? WPU, and L is equal to LPU. Okay, so W is equal to comma, it is WPU, and L is equal to LPU, because this is the pull up transistor, so the length and width will be represented with WPU and LPU. Okay, so sorry, here we will consider ZPD1, okay, and here also WPU1 and LPU1, okay, right? So in the previous discussion, whatever I have taken, that is also WPD, LPD1 and WPD1. Okay, so here IDS is equal to this one, right? So now if I substitute these values in this equation, so what I will get? Okay, so therefore I1 is equal to K into WPU1 by LPU1. Okay, WPU1 by LPU1, and it is VDS is equal to 0, so it is minus VTD whole square by 2. So therefore here we have, it is WPU by LPU. Actually ZPU is equal to LPU1. ZPU1 is equal to LPU1 by WPU1. Okay, so the same thing I am representing, I am substituting here. So what I will get? Okay, so that is nothing but I1 is equal to K into, okay, so it is WPU1 by LPU1, but here we have ZPU1, so it will be reverse. Okay, so that is 1 by ZPU1, and the remaining is as it is, we have, that is minus VTD whole square by 2. Okay, now this is nothing but I1. Okay, so I1 finally we got is, I1 is equal to K into 1 by ZPU1, okay, minus VTD whole square by 2. Okay, so now I know that I1 and R1, so that I can calculate V out 1. Okay, so therefore V out 1 is equal to, V out 1 is equal to I1 into R1. Okay, so therefore V out 1 is equal to what you will get here. So here we will get I1 is equal to what? K into 1 by ZPU1, and it is minus VTD whole square by 2 multiply with this one, R1. So it is ZPD by K 1 by VTD minus VT. Okay, 1 by VTD minus VT. So here any cancellations we have? So this one will be cancelled here, K with K. Okay, so here we have, I have done a small mistake that in the previous one it is LPD1 by WPD1. So here also we will get it is 1, ZPD1. Okay, so pull down transistor 1. So it is nothing but how you can calculate, that is WPD1 and at the same time LPD1. So but ZPD1 is nothing but LPD1 by WPD1. So in the previous one I have missed that representation of suffix PD1 and WPD1 and LPD1. Okay, so you can take care of that, right? So here it is 1 by ZPU1 and 1 by ZPD1. So these two will be cancelled, K and K, and the resultant equation is nothing but V out 1 is equal to, so what we have here, ZPD1 by ZPU1, ZPD1 by ZPU1 multiply with minus VTD whole square by 2 into VDD minus VT. Okay, so this is the V out 1. Okay, so this one is nothing but V out 1. So this equation I will take it as equation number 2. Okay, so this is the calculation of the output of the inverter 1. Okay, the output of inverter 1. And that output is passes through the inverter 2 through the two pass transistors. Okay, so now we have to calculate in the similar manner the R2, I2 and at the same time VR2. Okay, we'll do that now. Right, I will extend the same discussion for this inverter too also, but here one point we have to remember is the input for this inverter 2 is nothing but directly we cannot get VDD here. So because this is the output, suppose VDD is the output here, okay, if VDD is the output, this will be passes through the pass transistors, that is this pass transistor and this pass transistor, and it will be gives it cannot give the same VDD value here, it will give the degraded value. Okay, so degraded means it will use that this transistor use some threshold voltage and here also some threshold voltage, and if you consider VTP is the average threshold voltage, if VTP is the average threshold voltage of these pass transistors, then the inverter 2 input is nothing but VDD minus VTP. Okay, here VTP is what? Average threshold voltage of pass transistors. Okay, now what I am doing, I am extending this, the same discussion to the inverter 2. Okay, but here only one thing will be different, that is nothing but input is VDD minus VTP instead of VDD. Okay, so that's what we have to remember, and I will extend the same thing and I will find out what is the Vout one. So here this transistor is enhancement transistor, that is I am taking T4, it will be in non-saturation region. Okay, so for non-saturation region IDS is equal to that is K into W by L. It is VDS minus VT into VDS minus VDS square by 2. Right? So here the input for this transistor is VDD minus VTP. Because this one is always in saturation region, depletion mode. But this one is the input will vary. That input is VDD minus VTP. So here VGS is equal to VDD minus VTP. Okay. So VDD minus VTP. And VT is nothing but what? The threshold voltage as it is. And here we have VDS is equal to VDS2. Very small value. Okay. So the same discussion what we have done here, we will extend that one to this here also for this transistor and this transistor. Okay, so therefore IDS is equal to, so what you will get here, it is pull down transistor, so WPD2 by LPD2, it is VGS is nothing but VDD minus VTP, so that is VDD minus VTP minus VT, and here I am taking that the common by substituting that VDS1. So here I will get here VDS2 by 2 multiply with VDS2. Directly I am writing here. Okay. So now here what I have to calculate? I have to calculate R2. Okay. So R2 is nothing but so if I consider this one as IDS2. Okay. IDS is equal to IDS2 here. So therefore it will becomes what? VDS2 by IDS2. So that what you will get? So if I divide this VDS2 by IDS2, IDS2 is this one. So it is VDS2 by, so it becomes K into WPD by LPD2. That is nothing but I am writing like this. That is 1 by ZPD2. And here we have is VDD minus VTP minus VT minus VDS2 by 2, and it is multiplied with VDS2. Okay, so now these two will be cancelled. So these two will be cancelled. Right, So what is the remaining here? R2 is equal to here. That is what we'll get here. So the ZPD will goes up. So it is ZPD 2 by K into VDD minus. So VDD minus VTP minus VT. So here also I am neglecting the VDS2 value because it is very small. Okay. Neglect VDS 2 by 2. Okay. VDS 2 by 2. So I got the R2 value. Now I have to calculate the same whatever we have applied for this one. We have to calculate here. Okay. Now for saturation region, saturation mode of T2 is here, this depletion transistor, pull down transistor, okay, pull up transistor here. So therefore, how we can calculate here, IDS is equal to what? K into WPU2 by LPU2 multiply with the VGS minus VT, okay, so VGS minus VT, right, whole square by 2, VGS minus VT whole square by 2. So here it is a depletion MOSFET, so I will write here IDS is equal to I2, and this one is WPU2 by LPU2, it is 1 by ZPU2, and it is VGS is equal to 0 and VT is equal to VTD, right? VTD is threshold voltage of depletion MOSFET. Okay, so therefore what you will get here if I substitute those things in this equation, so I will get I2 is equal to K into, it is 1 by ZPU2, or we can also write this one as K by ZPU2, and it is VTD minus VTD whole square by 2. Okay, so here we got I2 and R2. So we can calculate what? Vout2. Okay, so therefore we can calculate, I am taking off this one. For Vout2 is equal to I2 multiply with R2. Okay, so that is nothing but R2 is what here we got? R2 is nothing but ZPD2 by K into VDD minus VTP minus VT. Okay, VTP minus VT multiply with this one, that is K by P ZPU2 minus VTD whole square by 2. Okay, so here this K and K will be cancelled, and the remaining equation what we got is nothing but Vout2 is equal to ZPD2 by ZPD2 and it is minus VTD whole square by 2 multiply with it is 2 VDD minus VTP minus VT. Okay, so this is the equation what we got for equation number 2. Right, I'm taking this one is equation number 3. So this one is the Vout2 and that one is the Vout1. So if I equate Vout1 is equal to Vout2 from equation 2 and 3, if I equate Vout1 and Vout2, so what I will get here is ZPD1 by ZPU1 is equal to multiply with minus VTD whole square by 2 into VDD minus VT. that is equal to ZPD 2 by ZPU 2, okay, and it is minus VTD whole square by 2 into VDD minus VTP minus VD, okay. So here we have minus VTD whole square is there and minus VDD whole square is there. So if I cancel that one, okay, what is the remaining thing where I will get is nothing but I want ZPD 2 by ZPE 2. So here, therefore, what I will get here, ZPD 2 by ZPU 2, ZPD 2 by ZPE 2, so it will come here. So this will and this will cancel. And what we will get here, it is equal to ZPD 1 by ZPU 1. ZPD 1 by ZPE 1 as it is and it will comes here so that it is multiplied with here 2 and 2 will also will cancel and it is VDD minus VTP minus VT by VDD minus VT. Okay, so here this is nothing but VDD minus VTP, so it will comes here and this will as it is it will be present here, so it is VDD minus VT. Right, now substitute here the threshold voltage or average threshold voltage of pass transistors VTP is equal to VTP is equal to 0.3 VDD and VT is equal to, we know that the threshold voltage of enhancement transistor is 0.2 VDD. Okay, so if I substitute those values here, so what I will get is ZPD 2 by ZPU 2 is equal to, it is multiplication of ZPD 1 by ZPU 1, okay. So it is VDD minus, here it is what? Minus VTP minus VT. So VDD minus 0.3 VDD minus 0.2 VDD by it is VDD minus 0.2 VDD. Okay, VDD minus 0.2 VDD. Now, here, if I consider that ZPD2 by ZPD2 by ZPU2, so what I will get here, it is ZPD1 by ZPU1 multiply with, what you will get here, VDD minus 0.5 VDD. So, it is nothing but 0.5 VDD by 0.8 VDD. So here we have ZPD2 by ZPE2 and ZPD1 by ZPU1 and it is multiplied with 0.5 VDD and 0.8 VDD and these two will be cancelled. Okay, so I will write this one, I will rewrite this one as ZPU2 pull up by ZPD2 is equal to pull up by pull down ratios. So it is ZPU1 by ZPD1, okay, pull down ratio. So it is nothing but multiply with, it is reverse, it is nothing but 8 by 5, okay, right, it is 8 by 5, okay. So here this one 8 by 5 means it is approximately we will get 8 by 5 around 1.6. Okay, so I will take that one as approximately 2. This one is approximately 2. So here ZPU2 by ZPD2 is equal to approximately, that is it is ZPU1 by ZPD1. For this inverter I will take that ratio as 4 by 1 and it is approximately taken as 2. So therefore ZPU2 by ZPD2 is equal to 8 by 1. Okay. Or we can also write ZPU2 is to ZPD2 is equal to 8 is to 1. Okay. So this is the equation we have. ZPU2 is to ZPD2, that is equal to 8 is to 1. So therefore, for a transistor, that is pull up to pull down ratio for an NMOS inverter driven through one or more pass transistors, then the pull up to pull down ratio will have is ZPU2 by ZPD2 is equal to 8 by 1, or ZPU2 is to ZPD2 is equal to 8 is to 1. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Subscribe our channel.